वेलकम टू ICS महेश पीयू कॉलेज यूट्यूब चैनल। आई एम अर्पिता हुद्दा। टेंसेस आर द बेसिक फाउंडेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज एंड अ प्री रिक्विजिट टू लर्न एक्टिव पैसिव वॉइसेस एंड रिपोर्टेड स्पीच विच आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट सिलेबस ऑफ सेकेंड PUC। वॉट एवर वी कॉन्वर्स in a day falls into 12 tenses, which are majorly divided into present tense, past tense and future tense. We need to understand that verb forms an important element of the sentence. The verb forms which we use in these 12 tenses are present tense, past tense, past participle and present participle. To make it simple, we have coded them as V1, V2, V3, V4. We will take up the example of an irregular verb. For example, write. The present tense is write. Past tense is wrote, the V3 is written, and the present participle form of it is writing. In the same way, an example for a regular verb, talk, present tense, talked, past tense, talked, past participle, and talking in present participle. An important observation: in the regular verbs, the past tense and the past participle sound the same and has similar spelling too. It is the same in case of some of the irregular verbs too. Auxiliary verbs play a major role in expressing tenses. Auxiliary verbs used in tenses are be auxiliary verbs, have auxiliary verbs and do auxiliary verbs. We call them as primary auxiliary verbs. Even auxiliary verbs too have V1, V2, V3, V4 forms, that is present tense, past tense, past participle and present participle forms. Let us go through the be auxiliary verb. The present tense of be auxiliary verb are am, is, are. The past tense is was, were. Past participle been and present participle being. The reason for the options in present tense, that is am, is, are, is mainly to facilitate the person of the subject in a sentence. All the 8 persons. That is the reason why we have options. Moving on to have auxiliary verb. Present tense have has, once again to facilitate the person of the subject. Past tense had, past participle had, present participle, that is V4, having. Do auxiliary verb. In the V1 present tense we have do does. Past tense did, past participle done and present participle doing. We will deal with individual tenses now. The first and foremost present tense. There are 4 types of tenses expressed in present. Simple present tense, which is also called as present indefinite tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense. Simple present tense, which is also known as present indefinite tense. This tense simply mentions the action in the present but does not tell the exact stage of the action. That's the reason why it is also called as present indefinite, because the stage of the action is indefinite in this tense. Example, Amit writes a novel. In this we understand that the action of writing is happening in the present, but we don't know exactly the stage of the action. The simple formula that enables us to understand simple present tense is subject. We use V1 form and followed by the object. Present continuous tense. This tense tells us that the action is in progress or happening in the present. Example, Amit is writing a novel. The action of writing is going on in the present. The formula for this is subject, amis are auxiliary verbs depending upon the person of the subject. We always use ing form, the V4 form in continuous tenses, whether it is present continuous, past continuous or future continuous, and then followed by the object. This is a formula. Present perfect tense. The very title indicates the meaning of the tense. This tense indicates that the action is completed in the present. Amit has written a novel. The action of writing is completed in the present. Formula, subject, have, has, depending on the person of the subject, V3 and object. Every perfect tense, whether it is present perfect, past perfect or future perfect, always makes use of past participle form of the verb. Present perfect continuous tense. This tense informs us that an action is completed at that moment in the present but has continued till date. Amit has been writing a novel. He has begun it and has continued to carry out that action. Formula, subject, has been or have been, ing form of the verb and object. As we have continuity in this, so once again we need to remember we have to use ing form of the verb. Past tense. There are four types of tenses in past tense. Simple past tense, which also is known as past indefinite tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense, past perfect continuous tense. Simple past tense, which is also known as past indefinite tense. This tense simply mentions the action taken place in the past but does not tell us accurately the stage of the action. Amit wrote a novel. We understand what action took place in the past, but we will not know what is the stage of the action. That's the reason it is called as past indefinite. Formula, subject, V2 plus object. Past continuous tense. This tense tells us that the action was in progress and was happening in the past. Amit was writing a novel. Subject was or were depending upon the number as well as the person of the subject. And as it is a continuous tense, we have already discussed, we use ing form of the verb, present participle form of the verb, V4, and the object. Past perfect tense. This tense tells us that the action has completed in the past. It's over. Amit had written a novel. Subject had. And V3, because perfect tense is always used, past participle form of the verb and then the object. Present perfect continuous tense. This tense informs us that an action is completed at that moment in the present but has continued till date. Amit has been writing a novel. He has begun it and has continued to carry out that action. Formula: subject has been or have been, ing form of the verb and object. As we have continuity in this, tenses are the basic foundation of English language and a prerequisite to learn active passive voices and reported speech, which are the important syllabus of second PUC. Simple future tense or future indefinite tense. This tense merely tells us that the action which will take place in the future but does not tell us about the accurate stage of the action. Amit will write a novel, but what will be the stage of his action will not be known. The formula: subject will model, which is the indicator of the future tense. It must be used because we are expressing future. And the V1 form of the verb form and then the object. Future continuous tense. This tense tells that the action will be in progress or will be happening at that moment in future. Amit will be writing a novel. Subject will be ing form of the verb V4 and then the object. Future perfect tense. This tense indicates that the action will have completed or is over in future at the time. Amit will have written a novel. Formula: subject will have V3 and object. We need to remember that there won't be change in will have or will has, because the future tense makes use of only have and nowhere has. Future perfect continuous tense. This tense informs that the action will be over but will continue to prevail till the time in future. Amit will have been writing a novel. He will have begun the action but will have continued with the same action for a longer period. To express this, we make use of future perfect continuous tense. Subject will have been and V4 form of the verb and then the object.